Counting the occurrences of each letter in a text could be useful, especially if you want to do some frequency analysis and break a cipher, like the Caesar cipher. Luckily, in this video, you're going to learn how to make a program that does just that. Okay, so here we've got a few sentences, okay, with a triple quotes string, okay? I haven't made them up myself. I actually used a generator, so if you find them weird, you know why. And here I've got a string containing all the letters of the English alphabet, okay? Of course, here you could use, like, you could ask the user to enter something like input, enter, text, something like that, okay? Instead of having this thing here. But I'm just going to stick to these amazing sentences. So let's comment this out, okay? Okay, so first of all, I'm going to create a dictionary where the keys will be the letters, so A, B, C, the string, and all the values will be zero at first. Okay, so to do that, I'm going to use dictionary comprehension, which is similar to list comprehension. So letters, dictionary, letter, zero, for letter in letters, like that. So basically, I go through all these letters, so one by one, so A, this is the first, and I add to the dictionary a key value pair with the key being A, the string A, and the value zero. And then the second time would be B. So the key will be the string B and then the value zero, etc., etc. We can actually print the result. So letters, dictionary, let's save it and run it like that. So as you can see, A zero, B zero, C zero, etc., etc. Okay, so let's comment this out. Perfect. Then I'm going to go through all the letters inside of these sentences. Okay, so something like for char in text lower. Okay, I'm going to convert all the letters to lowercase. Then if the char is in letters, I'm going to add one to the right key in the dictionary. Okay, so basically I go through the letters. So the first time H is converted to lowercase. Then is H in letters? Yes, I've got the H here. Okay, so I'm going to add one to the key H inside of the letters dictionary. So this key here, like here, this is going to be one, and then two, three, etc., whatever. And then E does the same thing, etc., etc. And then I need to get the total number of letters in the text that I will then use to calculate the percentage, because we're not just going to count the occurrences, but we're also going to calculate the percentage. Okay, so let's say that the occurrences of E are like the 10% of the total, etc., etc. So you've got the percentages, which is kind of cool. And so to get the total number, we don't need to count the spaces, all the characters, the dot, etc. And we're going to do that like this. So we're going to do something like total letters starts out zero, and then for letter in letters, total number like that, letters dictionary, letter. Okay, so we're going to go through all the letters here, so A, and then we're going to add the value of the key, the specific key in the dictionary. So it starts out A, let's say the value is 10, so it goes like total number letters 10, then it goes to B, B is 2, it adds 2, so 12, etc., etc. So you've got the total number of letters. And you can do this in another way. So instead of doing something like that, you do something like total letters like that is equal to the sum letters dictionary like that dot values like this. Perfect. So it goes through all the values, okay, because values actually returns a sort of list of all the values, so 10, 2, 15, etc. And then using the sum, you actually add all the values in the list together, okay, you sum them up, and you get the total number of letters. Perfect. Then I need to sort all the key value pairs according to the values, meaning I want the most used letter first, okay, because if I'm going to print all the letters, there would be something like, let's say A, 10, B, 2, C, 15, okay? Instead, I want something like C, 15, A, 10, B, 2, okay? So I want them ordered according to the values, okay, according to the occurrences. I don't want them ordered alphabetically, okay? To do this, we're going to use list comprehension, okay? This is going to be a little bit complex, so if you don't really understand what I'm doing, maybe after this video, you can go and watch the other video about list comprehension where I actually explain you better the concept of the list comprehension, okay? So I'm going to do something like sorted pairs. I'm actually going to sort them using the sorted built-in function. Then I'm going to start the list comprehension. So a tuple value key, okay, for key value in letters dictionary items, and then here reverse true, and I'm going to explain you why I'm doing this. So this is basically the list comprehension, this one, and this is about the sorted method. So this is the list comprehension. So here basically I'm going through all the items in the dictionary, and items, this method here returns a list of tuples, and each tuple will have the key as the first element and the value as the second element, okay? And here, as you can see, I'm unpacking it. I'm using multiple assignment, also called tuple unpacking, okay? So instead of having like just one variable here, my tuple, and then having to use the my tuple 0 to get the first value, and then my tuple 1 using the indexes, I'm just unpacking them like that, okay? So the first iteration will be key A, and then the value of the occurrences, the number of occurrences, let's say 10, okay? And each iteration, I'm adding this tuple to the list that I'm creating, okay? But notice that I'm using the value first. So let's say the number of occurrences of A is 10, so you will have 10 here, and then the key A, okay? Then the second time around, you add another tuple with value 2, for example, and the key B, the string B, and then the C, etc., etc. So this one will be a list of tuples, and inside the tuples, the first element is the number of occurrences, and the second element is the letter, okay? Then I'm going to sort them, and that's why I decided to use the value first and then the key, because when you sort a list of tuples, Python actually uses the first element to sort them, okay? So if I were to use the key first here, Python would sort them in alphabetical order, so A, B, C, etc. But as I'm using the value first, then Python will sort them like 1, 10, 11, 25, etc., etc., okay? And also I'm using reverse true because I don't want them to be like 1, 10, etc., okay? But I want them to be like 25, 10, 5, 2, etc. So I want the letter with the most occurrences to be the first of the list, okay? I hope that makes sense. If you find this difficult, please go and watch the video about the list comprehension, because there I actually explain it so much better, okay? So we can actually print the sorted pairs, so we can see, you can see what we actually get. So let's see. As you can see, it starts 26 E16 O A16 R13, okay? As you can see, it starts from the one with most occurrences, and then it goes down, 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 down. So this is what we needed. If I had reverse false, or actually I didn't have reverse at all, you would get something like that. As you can see, it starts out like that, and it goes up, up, up. But this is not what I want, so I'm just going to use true that. Okay, perfect. And then I want to show you what happens if I do something like key and value here, so maybe things will be a little bit clearer. As you can see, it starts Z, Y, X, because I'm actually using reverse true. So as you can see, it orders the list according to the letters, okay, not the numbers. As you can see, 2, 1, 0, 9, etc. So this is not what we want, okay? So that's why I actually used value and then key. Hopefully now that's clearer. Perfect, let's comment that out. Okay, then I need to loop through this new list and print the count of each letter and the percentage, okay? By the way, if you're enjoying the video, like it, and also subscribe to the channel for more videos like that. And also if you want, comment down below, because I really love to read your comments, okay? So we're going to go through the sorted pairs. So for value, I'm gonna use multiple assignment here as well. In sorted pairs like that. And here we're going to create the percentage like this. But I'll also show you how you can do that directly inside the F string. So value, the number of letters. So this is the percentage. And I haven't really told you that what we're going to do here is part of a method called frequency analysis. And this is a method that was actually used to break ciphers like the Caesar Cipher. And I actually made a video on how to create the Caesar Cipher program to encrypt and decrypt messages. So if you want to learn how to do that, check out the video after this one. You'll find the link in the cards up above and in the description box down below. Okay, so I'm going to print something like F letters, letter actually, value, okay, then the T, which stands for tab, okay, this is to make things more table-like, and then I'm going to do something like percentage, to like that, and then the percentage like this, and then the parentheses. And this is the same as doing something like this. As I said, doing something directly inside the F string, and the F string actually will work out the percentage for us. Okay, so let's actually duplicate this thing here. Okay, so instead of having percentage here, I'm gonna delete that. I'm gonna delete the percent sign like that. I'm gonna do something like this, and then 2%. Okay, doing this, Python will calculate the percentage of this with 2 decimals. Pretty cool. One important thing to know is that probably if you sum all the percentages up without approximation, you're going to get a result that is not like 100.00000, but you're gonna get something like 100.00004 or something like that, okay? And this is because floating point operations are approximated, and this could lead to results like this, okay? And same thing, if we sum all the rounded percentages up, we're not going to get exactly 100, okay? Maybe 100.01 or 99.96 or something like that, okay? Because numbers are rounded, okay? And this is just to explain you in case you were going to try and see with results, okay? But of course here, we don't need to be extremely precise, so we're not gonna worry about that. Okay, so let's actually try to run this. Let's comment this out because we don't need that. And let's actually try to run that and see what we actually get. All right, so you've got 26 occurrences of E, and this is the 14.36% of the total. And then you've got O, A, R. Okay, so you've got the list. As you can see, everything is ordered from the one with the most occurrences, and then down, 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 down. Okay, it wouldn't make sense to have something like A, 16, B, whatever, 4, C, 6, but it wouldn't make sense. That's so much easier to read it like that, okay? I'm not actually going to go a lot into this, but what you would do to crack a cipher is you would get a table like the one you see on the screen, and you would compare the percentages and replace the letters with similar percentages until you find something that makes sense, like a word or something like TH, like the, etc., etc. And of course, there is always going to be a little trial and error, but this is how you would use this to break a cipher, basically. Okay? All right, guys, this video has ended, but it doesn't mean you should stop learning. That's why I've picked this other really interesting video about Python for you to watch. Click on it, and I'll see you there.